Don't forget to subscribe and turn the notifications. We upload daily, and check the source of this video to view all the images and videos if there was any. After the recent passing of Senator John McCain of Arizona, politicians and citizens alike have been making public comments regarding their relationship with him, his life, and his service. One of the most prominent of them all is former Alaskan Governor Sarah Palin, who was Senator McCain's vice presidential candidate. What she had to say will likely not surprise you if you know anything about their relationship. The Daily Mail reported, former Alaska Governor Sarah Palin says late Senator John McCain will be remembered as an American hero, but admits it was unfortunate that he was surrounded by people who weren't serving him well during their run for office. McCain died at his Arizona home at 4:28 p.m. on Saturday, surrounded by his wife Cindy and their family. In an exclusive interview with Daily Mail TV, Palin, 54, and her husband Todd, 53, reflected on her time as McCain's running mate during the 2008 presidential election and revealed her frustration over his political hangers-on. "I respect his military service. I think it's unfortunate that he had people around him, and they continued to be around him for a very long time, who weren't serving him well," she said. "They certainly weren't serving the country well with what they were trying to do. I believe he was told things about what America really wanted or really needed because he's been in that DC bubble for so many years. I don't think inherently he necessarily was really connected, so he did rely on people telling him, in polls, telling him, and he went from there." Trending, John McCain stuck it to Trump in final requests before his death. "I think that's unfortunate because he had some strange people around him and disloyal people, and you know, I don't say that as like hate speech or griping about it, it's just a fact they were just some not nice people," Todd added. "But when she was doing debate prep for a big debate with Biden and just wanted to talk about some issue, she could have like four or five people around her with all the cue cards and all this and sit there for hours and not accomplish much. But sit in the back of the bus with John and her, and it was awesome to watch. So, I just respected John and he had a huge heart, you know," Sarah said. McCain had agreed with her about not letting other people mold you into something you're not. "You can't do that. You can't be insincere and not genuine and accomplish what needs to be done, but yeah, that was a huge lesson," she said. "If it was just John McCain and me, or just our families together, it was awesome. Those were the good times." When asked on what she believed was McCain's political legacy, she said the senator will be remembered in high respects for his military service. "The unfortunate part about it will be that I think some of the people around him still try to undermine us. Part of that legacy, unfortunately, will be some of these people that had influence on him will, unfortunately, they really took advantage of, and that wasn't good." The former governor and her husband also spoke out against claims that McCain had regretted picking her as his running mate. The 81-year-old revealed in his memoir, The Restless Wave, published in April, that he wished he had chosen Connecticut Senator Joseph Lieberman as his VP instead. In an earlier interview with Daily Mail TV in May, Palin had said she attributed his statements to his ghostwriters. "I was reading part of his book and he had nothing but praise her. He had one little sentence where he was saying, 'Maybe I should have picked Joe,' Todd said. 4 or 5 little words. He praised her and how he selected her, but that's how it works. That's how the perception in the media works." Sarah reiterated that McCain had never told her those sentiments himself. "Well, with that headline though, that he evidently regretted picking me, well, my thought was, well, he's never said that to me. We've always had great conversations and thankfulness that I accepted the opportunity and was given the opportunity. It's all been good." Palin went on to say that over the years since the presidential election, she has had conversations with the late senator and that their relationship remained pleasant and amicable. One where they could agree to disagree when need be and agree where it was important. While she admitted to conversations getting heated, she maintained that what she will remember most about him was his big heart and his higher calling to service. Furthermore, she called upon the family stories of how the McCain family and the Palin family interacted and spent time together. She vigorously defended his military record, saying that anyone who speaks negatively on it is someone whom she would aggressively criticize. Something she indicated she would do for her own children as well. "Share if you think Palin's statement was good. Share if you are sad about Senator McCain's passing. Share if your thoughts and prayers go out to the McCain family."